हेलो एंड वेलकम टू द प्रेजेंटेशन ऑन डायनामिक्स ऑफ मशीनरी यूनिट नंबर वन सिंगल डिग्री ऑफ फ्रीडम सिस्टम्स। सो इन द लास्ट प्रेजेंटेशन वी हैव सीन द कंटेंट्स अप टू दिस एंड द लेटेस्ट प्रेजेंटेशन वी हैव सीन द डैम्प वाइब्रेशन डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ डैम्पिंग विस्कस डैम्पिंग ओवर दैट इन केस विस्कस डैम्पिंग वी हैव सीन द ओवर डैम्प कंडीशन एंड नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड द क्रिटिकली डैम्प कंडीशन एंड अंडर डैम्प सिस्टम्स। ओके सो For having the system to be critically damped, we will be using the zeta is equal to 1. So in this case, zeta is equal to 1. That means C is equal to CC. So your expression for roots, that is S1 and S2, was like this. So if I put this zeta that is equal to 1 in this expression, I will get that S1 is equal to minus omega n and S2 will be equal to again minus omega n. It means these two roots are real and equal. So the solution of this differential equation becomes C1 e raised to S1 of t plus C2 e raised to S2 of t. So S1 and S2 will be minus omega n minus omega n t. So I can combine this, that is equal to C1 plus C2 into t into in bracket, bracket complete, e raised to minus zeta omega n t. So this is my expression. So now I have to find out the values of this C1 and C2 by using the initial conditions. So the initial condition is t equal to 0 at x equal, and definitely you will find out here that when t is equal to 0, x equal to x0, and at t equal to 0, x dot is equal to 0, the same initial conditions which you have used for the overdamp condition. So first I have to find out the value of x dot by using the previous equation. So in the previous equation, this is, consider this as a first function and this is a second function, and find out the derivative of this. So first function e raised to minus omega n t into second function, that is c2 plus c1 plus c2 t, that is second function, into ddx of first, that is minus omega n as it is into e raised to a minus omega n t. So x dot will be equal to, now what I will do is I will just try to simplify this, since here there is one term of c2 and here also there is one term of c2 here. So let us put the initial condition in the equation of displacement. So you will get x0 that is equal to c1, and when you put that initial condition, second initial condition, into the equation of velocity, you will get this x dot is equal to 0, that is equal to c2. As you are putting this value of t here 0, so e raised to minus omega n t becomes 1. So c2 minus, here again the same thing, so you will get c minus c1 into omega n, and therefore from here you will find out that the c2 is equal to c1 into omega n, and therefore c2 is equal to, now you can have the value of c1, that is nothing equal to x0, so c2 is equal to x0 into omega n. Now if you put this value of c1 and c2 into the equation of differential equation solution, that is x, so you will get x is equal to x0 plus x0 into omega n, bracket complete, e raised to minus zeta omega n t, and you will find out that this variation of the x with respect to time t will be observed like this. So generally it will be observed in case of a door closing system in most of the offices. So once you open the door, slowly it will get its mid position again. So this is what is being achieved here. So in this case you will observe that the value of x decreases as time increases and finally becomes 0 at a time which tends to infinity. So this is a periodic motion. Okay, hence the displaced body is brought to equilibrium position in minimum possible time. So you will observe that the critically damped condition, in minimum possible time, you can achieve the equilibrium condition of the system. So this is what is about the critically damped condition. Now we will see the next, that is underdamped system. It means when the value of zeta is less than 1. So when the value of zeta is less than 1, definitely then you have to make certain adjustment in this particular roots equation S1 and S2. Because here it is zeta is less than 1, so zeta square minus 1, this term is not possible. So we are going to rearrange this term such that this minus zeta becomes as it is, and when I am going to put this 1 minus zeta square, so I am taking this minus sign common, so minus 1 in under root is nothing but equal to I. So minus 1 will be adjusted such that this I will be coming out, that is an imaginary. So you will find out here that these two roots are imaginary roots, okay, and complex roots. So one is positive sign here and another is a negative sign here. Okay, so when I write this displacement equation again, so I will get c1 e raised to minus zeta plus I in under root 1 minus zeta square into omega n t plus c2 into e raised to power minus zeta plus I in under root 1 minus zeta square omega n t. So if I take this e raised to minus zeta omega n t common term, in bracket I will get this c1 into e raised to power this term plus c2 into e raised to power that term. Okay, so putting this under root of 1 minus zeta square into omega n as omega d. Now because we are going to define this additional term here, that is called as frequency of damped vibration. So it is natural frequency of damped vibration omega d, which is equal to under root of 1 minus zeta square into omega n. So this term is here as well as here. So I will write this term as omega d. So my expression of x becomes e raised to minus zeta omega n t into in bracket c1 will be as it is e raised to I omega dt plus c2 e raised to minus I omega dt, like this. Okay, now the same expression of x, I am writing it again here, and now I will express this e raised to I omega dt in terms of this cos and sine terms. So x is equal to e raised to minus zeta omega nt, okay, into in brackets c1 will be as it is. So e raised to I omega dt is written as cos of omega dt plus I into sine of omega dt plus c2 into cos of omega dt minus I into sine of omega dt. Okay, so here there is two terms of cos, c1 cos, okay, and c2 cos, and there are two terms of c1 sine and c2 sine. So let us combine these cos terms and sine terms. I will get c1 plus c2 cos of omega dt plus I into c1 minus c2 sine of omega dt. So as x is a displacement, hence it cannot have the imaginary part. Hence the new constants c1 plus c2, I am going to define it as a, and c1 minus c2 I am going to define as b. So these are called as complex conjugate of each other. So now your displacement expression x becomes e raised to minus zeta omega n t, and c1 plus c2 that I am writing it as a into cos of omega dt, and that another term is writing as b sine of omega dt. So in this case now let us consider that this a is nothing but equal to x sine of psi, and b is x cos of psi. Okay, that is nothing but the phase difference over there, and therefore tan of psi will be equal to a by b, and therefore psi will be equal to tan inverse of a by b, and x is equal to under root of a square plus b square. So using this substitution, I will get the displacement x, that is equal to capital X e raised to minus zeta omega n t into in bracket sine of psi. So I am writing this a as a sine of psi here, and this is cos omega dt is already there. Then b I am writing as x into cos of psi. Okay, so x is already there, so we take cos of psi and sine of omega dt. So it is sine a cos b plus cos a sine b. Using that, I can combine this and get the displacement x is equal to capital X e raised to minus zeta omega n t into sine of omega dt plus psi. So the amplitude occurs when this sine of omega dt plus psi is equal to 1. Thus, the amplitude at the end of the first cycle is x1 at time t. So you can see here, this is suppose the first end of the first cycle, so you will get this x1 at time t. And then one more cycle when it completes, so you will get x2 here, second amplitude. So the first amplitude x1 will be capital X e raised to minus zeta omega n t. Okay, so here you can see that x sine phi is specified here. This is nothing but the phi. Okay, this is the time period. So one cycle completes from here to here, so this is the time period. So x1 you have got here, that is first amplitude obtained here. And after one cycle, if you have to get the amplitude, so x2 will be equal to capital X e raised to minus zeta omega n t. Okay, so it is t becomes 2t, means it is completing one more cycle additional. So after two cycles, it will be the next amplitude. Now, if I have to get the relationship between this x1 and x2, so I will take the ratio of log to the base e x1 by x2, that is equal to log to the base e of x into e raised to minus zeta omega n t upon x into e raised to minus zeta omega n 2t. So x will get cancelled out from here, and this e raised to minus d omega n t minus minus plus it is g 2 zeta omega n t. So 2 minus 1 it becomes 1 zeta omega n t will remain here. So and this is the limit called as logarithmic decrement delta. So you will find out how much will be the decrement in the value of this particular displacement after one cycle. So this much is the decrement, that is called as delta. So it is also called as a rate of decay of amplitude. So natural logarithm of the ratio of any two successive amplitude on the same side of the mean position is called as the logarithmic decrement. So here now we can again define the time period, that is equal to 2 pi by omega d. So 2 pi is constant, omega d is nothing but equal to 1 under root of 1 minus zeta square into omega n. So time period we can define it as, suppose it is a time t2 here and this is time t1 here. So difference of this t2 minus t1, that is 2 pi by omega d. So I will write time period equation once again, that is 2 pi upon in under root 1 minus zeta square into omega n. So this is nothing but the expression for the time period. Now we will have to write once again the logarithm decrement, that is delta is equal to log to the base e of x1 by x2. So this is given as log to the base e raised to zeta omega n tp, because it is a time period, one time period. So delta is equal to zeta into omega n into tp, okay, as this is log to the base e and this is e again. So you will find out that this is equal to zeta omega n, I will write tp is equal to 2 pi by omega d, and then I am putting the value of omega d as under root of 1 minus zeta square into omega n. So I will find this, that omega n will get cancelled out. So I am getting the expression for delta, that is equal to 2 pi zeta upon in under root 1 minus zeta square. So this is most of the most important equation for the damped vibration to get the value of logarithmic decrement. Similarly, now if this delta is equal to ln of x1 by x2, or it is log to the base e of x2 by x3, same will be equal to x4, x3 by x4, like that, it will be continuous. So if I have to add this all the different logarithmic decrements, so I will write it is n into delta, that is equal to log to the base e of x1 by x2 plus log to the base e of x2 by x3 plus log to the base 10 of x3 by x4. Like this I will go on adding up to xn minus 1 by xn. So I will write here that n into delta will be equal to log to the base e of x0 by xn. Therefore the logarithmic decrement will be equal to 1 by n log to the base e of x0 by xn, where x0 is the amplitude at the start and xn is the amplitude after n number of cycles. So whatever the number of cycles are there, so first amplitude value and the last amplitude after n number of cycles, so I can divide this n here to get the logarithmic decrement. So this is also one of the important relationship for damped vibration. So in the next class we will see some numericals on equivalent stiffness, damping and the formulation of differential equation of motion to find the natural frequency of the system. So here we are going to stop. So thank you very much.